Savings rate sounds kind of complicated, but it actually isn't. Hi, I'm Jimmy Chang. I've been teaching college mathematics for almost a decade, and we're here to calculate the rather straightforward process of savings rate. It's a very simple formula here. All you really need is to figure out, over the course of the past year, how much you've saved, and then you need to figure out how much money you made in the past year, your amount of income. Because the formula is, you take the amount that you save, and then you divide by the amount of income. And that gives you an idea as to how much you actually saved over the past year. And we're going to run down a quick example for you. Suppose within the past year, you saved $3,000, but you made $50,000. It's not a lot, but you still saved quite a bit of money. And so to figure out your savings rate, you take your $3,000, use a calculator if you like, and divide that by $50,000, and round to, let's just say, two decimal places, and you will get 0.06. But that may not mean anything to you at the time, but it's always practical, if you like, to transform it to a percent so it gives you a better glimpse as to how much you actually saved. Now, just shift the decimal to the right two places, and as you can see, 0.06 is 6%. Now, it's actually not a bad savings rate. You saved 6% out of your income, and if you're happy with that savings rate, then definitely keep in mind that to keep saving $3,000 every year, but if you feel that in this case you could save more, then you know what to do for future reference for other years. Just save more than $3,000 and you will increase your savings rate. So, I'm Jimmy Chang, and that is exactly how you calculate your savings rate.